Welcome. My name is Peter Knoringa. I'm a professor of private sector and development at the Institute of Social Studies, Erasmus University, Rotterdam. This presentation is about social standards and how they co-determine when frugal innovations are also responsible innovations. My main point will be that frugal innovations are not automatically also responsible innovations. In the previous presentation, Professor Van Beers defined frugal innovations as innovations with reduced complexity and costs targeted at relatively poor consumers. I will argue that frugal innovations are not responsible innovations when the social standards applied in the production processes are either too high or too low. In this presentation, I'm taking the following steps. First, I introduce two key elements and one key characteristic of social standards, using the example of child labor. Second, I will argue that frugal innovations with too low social standards, for example, by exploiting workers or using child labor, cannot be considered responsible innovations. Third, I will show how frugal innovations with too high social standards are likely to create barriers of entry for new firms and thus obstruct new innovations. Fourth, I will combine the earlier points to conclude that frugal innovations contribute to economic development when social standards are as high as possible to ensure decent working conditions and as low as necessary to not stifle a next round of innovations. The first issue is then to introduce what are social standards, sometimes also called labor standards. These standards have two main elements. First, decent working conditions like a minimum wage and proper health and safety conditions. In a factory, this includes simple things like a fire extinguisher that really works. On farms, this includes protective clothing when dealing with chemicals. Second, so-called enabling rights, which includes freedom of association and the rights to collective bargaining. A social or labor standard needs to ensure that workers can form an association and that union leaders are not simply fired, or worse, by employers. A key complicating characteristic of social standards is that you can usually not see them. Take, for example, child labor. You cannot deduce from a t-shirt that you're buying or a cup of coffee that you're drinking whether the processing of that product has included the use of child labor. We call this a credence good, which means that you need to put trust in those who monitor these production processes. This monitoring can be done by government agencies, like a labor inspectorate, and sometimes this is also done by companies who wish to operate at a higher level of responsibility by monitoring their own social or ethical standard. It can also be done by non-governmental organizations like Fair Trade, who then monitor, for example, cooperatives of small farmers on not using child labor. The challenges related to monitoring are discussed in more detail in the reading that is attached to this session. While some governments are more effectively monitoring social or labor standards as compared to others, all governments face challenges with production processes in the informal economy, where many of the relatively poorer consumers buy most of their products. Now, after introducing the idea and practice of social standards, I now turn to the main argument of this web lecture. Frugal innovations are not always also responsible innovations, and social standards play an important role in explaining this point. When frugal innovations are based on stripping higher value products, one of the first things that producers may sacrifice are social standards, like minimum wages for workers, and they may cut back on health and safety conditions in order to reduce costs. For example, frugal innovations produced in the informal economy may actually not protect workers against exploitative working conditions. In such situations of too low social standards, frugal innovations cannot be seen as responsible innovations. Of course, this is not a simple yes or no issue, but a matter of trying to ensure as decent as possible working conditions. What it means is that one cannot only look at the technological or ethical dimensions of the product as such, but we also need to consider under what social conditions these frugal innovations are produced. The second main point is that social standards can also be too high. Many examples exist of large firms that successfully lobby with national governments and international agencies to create new entry barriers for new firms. Firms try to protect their vested interests and block new firms with new ideas to enter into the market, using, among others, their higher social standards as a way to protect their dominant market position. This type of protectionism is much criticized by firms from emerging economies who find it difficult to get access to European and US markets. In principle, higher social standards, of course, are a good thing. After all, who could be against, for example, higher wages or better health and safety conditions? But it becomes a different matter when established large firms can use such standards to create the impression that their way of doing things is the only legitimate way of doing business, which effectively creates new barriers to entry for new firms and thus obstructs innovation. This means that also too high social standards may hamper frugal innovations, as it obstructs innovation as such, and especially types of innovation that try to significantly reduce costs without sacrificing user value. Now, to conclude, frugal innovations are not responsible innovations when social standards are set either too low or too high. When the production of frugal innovation uses too low social standards, this can easily lead to exploitation of workers and therefore to unresponsible innovation and production processes. But social standards can also be set too high. In that scenario, large entrenched firms use unnecessarily high social standards, not for ethical reasons, but to protect their markets and to block new firms from entering into their markets. The next web lecture focuses on the impact of frugal innovations on inclusive development. This session has paved the way by already showing how frugal innovations are more likely to contribute to inclusive development when social standards are set as high as possible to ensure decent working conditions and as low as necessary to allow for new innovation opportunities. Thank you for your attention.